Now that the winter of 2022 to 2023 is well behind us, the Pacific Ocean has entered into a significant El Niño phase which has caused immense heat to build in parts of the US, with no end in sight. This video will look toward the next winter season and how the current El Niño may affect it. On average, an El Niño typically causes the polar jet stream to move far north, keeping Arctic air locked far into Canada and making the northern US and southern Canada warm and dry. The subtropical jet stream tends to travel the southern and eastern U.S., creating cooler and wetter conditions in the south and southeast. This El Niño will likely be moderate to strong, exacerbating these conditions. However, El Niño is not the only factor in our winters. The PNA, or Pacific North American Teleconnection Pattern, and NAO, or North Atlantic Oscillation, both significantly affect our weather. The PNA is currently expected to be positive, and the NAO expected to be weakly negative, which would cause cool conditions in the east and warmth in the west/northwest. Current modeling shows that the upcoming winter will likely be warm in the north and west, while average or cool in the south and east. The southeast looks to stay very wet over the winter, while the northwest, Ohio Valley, and Midwest may stay dry. Looking back through analog years, these conditions appear in many other El Niño years. Through all El Niño years since 2000, the southern and eastern half of the U.S. looks to stay cool, with the west being warm. Precipitation is also enhanced greatly along the east coast, while the Ohio Valley and northwest stay dry. These analogs lead to a first possible scenario this winter, where the east is colder and wetter, while the west is warm and dry. However, when looking back at the strongest El Niño, things change. The northern half of the U.S. looks to be mild and the south cool, and the southern tier stays wetter than normal while the Ohio Valley is still dry. With these scenarios in mind, my early predictions for the upcoming winter season were a blend of the two. Across both possibilities, the northwest stays warm and dry, leading to high confidence. The southwest looks to have a wet winter, with some cool spells throughout. The large gray section represents where I believe a typical winter can be expected. Temperatures and precipitation both look to be near average. Across the upper Midwest, things look to stay dry throughout the winter, with some cold and some warmth. The pink zone represents my boom or bust area. Depending on conditions, this area may end up with a ton of wintry precip, or a rainy winter. Across the deep south and Florida, it looks to stay soggy and cool, with a few bouts of severe weather likely. In the light blue shading, covering much of the northeast, residents should expect a fairly average season with more snow than last year in most areas. Temperatures may be either above or below average. Finally, across coastal New England and parts of the Mid-Atlantic, nor'easter potential will likely be heightened throughout the season, bringing heavy rain, ice, snow, and high winds more often than usual. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and subscribe, and hit the notification bell for future uploads. If you have any feedback, please leave a comment, and have a wonderful day.